Okay, welcome back, everyone. This is Erik Malkavian, Among the Pillars of Eternity. Still in the Deerwood. Let's continue. This rain. Trap, damn it. Let's get out of it.
Of course.
We can find some shelter underneath this, whatever that thing is. Get our bearings. Alright. Let's actually keep it warm. Learn more about the Lenkeys activities. Power machine leads, obtaining catacombs. I think I can discover them. Pursuing leads obtained. Right. Acolyte's vision showed me a mysterious ruin somewhere outside of Deerford. Letting he has sent operatives find sight, though their purpose is unknown to me. Got written down here. Someone named Baidmar showed me where to find Silver and Rilag, but he warned me to steer clear of the Glen Fountain tribe's guardian. Okay. Well, steering clear is not an option. So let's go. Crud. This fool's lost his mind. Let's bring it back to him, eh? Grieving mother? Find his mind in a moment. Go wide. He may have a bear or some sort of animal. Bring him down. Head that way. Ah! I knew it. Mark this little fool. Bring him down. I thought he might have more companions. Hologram, break off and take this guy. Enter, knock that fool down. Slow this little fool down. Let's go see how this plays out. Go! Haha, the little fool. Mark that fool, but it's too late. He's turned into a bear. They've chosen to stand back and do their doom. Fighting these fools. Okay, I'll murder this fool. Nice little eye strike to him.
Yes.
Austin. Good friend casts a nice little fireball. They're scared out of their wits. I'll give them something to be afraid of. He should be paralyzed. Actually missed. Traps. Not the same effects. Perfect. Another stun. Let's have her start firing her bow. Oops, no. Firing her bow at this enemy. Fireball, do them right. That lit up the night for them. Terrified. Can't even move. As their doom falls upon them. Yeah. Your pain has just begun, fool. Feel it now. As I freeze you, she blows you to bits. Very nice. Very nice indeed, family. You are family to me.
As you wish.
Wonderful, wonderful. Oh, wonderful. Let's see what we got here. What's going on? What happened here? The guy checked.
Ready,
that
watcher.
What in the world's going on with that? What was that?
Right.
Let's look at the items that we just received. On spears, clothing, armor, hide armor.
Your thoughts must flow deeply indeed.
Let's see what your accuracy is currently. 58. 24. Now, let's see this bow. Let's see what's attacking the same target as an ally. Okay, damage one attacks. Alright, can't. Holy power. What's that? Here, these tormented with nobility for nearly 5 years. Stolen from the cart of a wealthy merchant, the gilded crossbow quickly began to feature in their crimes. One thief would approach the target in question, while the other wailed a good friend from afar. Two were credited with many daring escapes, including one occasion in which one thief, Destin Hang, was freed at the last moment by a last minute bolt through the rope. No threat of pain or capture could faze them. It was said if either was caught alone, or they knew that sooner or later the good friend would be along to feed them. Add to the accuracy. Good friend. Burning curses. Accuracy. What am I missing? Set those arrows. So let's go ahead and enchantment. add to accuracy. For that, I will need... rubies. Okay. What bow is she using? I have a better bow than that. Let's go find this. Surely we can make this finer. And rubies. Okay. So then, set logo. And topaz. All right.
Of course.
Let's go to sneak.
Keeping an eye out.
Being experimented on currently. Settler's Arrow. Okay, one. So, the Settler's Arrow in this area. Let's look and see if we can find some more. Find some more settlers there. Oh! you come from? Wherever you came from, where you going back to? Who the fuck are you? Slide my blade and slice you to ribbons.
Of course.
These little fools. Get on this little fool. It'll knock this little fool down too. For all the misery. It all of its misery. Mark the prey. Shigani, eat it. Alos, when why? You will die, whatever you are. You're paralyzed, fool, now. Oh, I remember my fight. I'm seeing information on all this. Sad tale they are. Hopefully we can prevent creation of these beings in the future. Let's read a little bit more about Erik after, since we're going there. A territory comprised of the forest southeast of the Bale River. Populated indigenously by a group of loosely affiliated tribes collectively known as the Cliabans, and governed by a council of the six most powerful tribes. Irglanfoth is home to a large number of ruined and Cliaban sites which Cliabans hold sacred. Okay, ruins have been at the center of a number of large-scale conflicts with the Druid colonists. whose settlements often encroach on Glyphathan territory and frequently seek to plunder the room for their relics. Alright. Keep that in mind. I believe we're gonna have to pay a visit to the tribal leaders before we enter.
As you wish. I'll see what I can find.
Avoid any trouble. Alright. More trouble. It's rather hard to avoid trouble. Let's go. On the silent real. Okay, that's a crack pole. Travel case. Okay, so let's install it. They need help. I may have to go there very soon. For now.
This is the place. My big brother's last battle. I wish I could tell you what we're looking for.
Oh, thank you for reminding me, Eder.
Anything from that battle, I guess. Whatever 15 years of rain has him buried. You see my brother's ghost, you give me a holler, all right?
Right. That battle was. Now. Fragments of Shadow. Search the battlefield for signs of Saint Ward. Eder admits he isn't sure what he's looking for here. He's hoping for some sign of his brother's presence here that might provide a clue as to why he fought for Raidus Cirrus. Let's go. We shall look. A man stands before you. His face smeared with green and ochre dyes, hides and furs cover his body, holds a spear in one hand.
Estramore.
Back to your village, Estramore. You're lucky the three-tusked Telegar hunts out of the quarry today. Looking for a group of people who may have already entered the ruins. So are we. Runs his dumb long smooth with his staff. That is why we are here, Estramore. And that is why I decided to let you leave in peace. These individuals are my enemies too. If you let me in, I can bring them out to you. He laughs, and allow even more extra ones to trample sacred ground? Certainly not. I see the famed mathematical aptitudes of the Glyphathans were not overestimated. What will you do? We will wait. There inside, they must come out. And when they do, slides the fingertip along the point of the spear, shows you the drop of the blood. What do you know about Scribe and Rilag? It is sacred place of the builders, and neither enter your feet nor are shall sully its stones. The grasses, however, he grins up the spear, I'll gladly ward with your blood. Three Tustelagar, snarling with whines, have the farmers grown too fearful to even mention our name? We are the fierce of the six tribes of Erenglofton. We are the guardians of monuments here. I'll be going from now. I do not come this way again. Oh. I'll be back, you little fool.
Not much here.
Impression. Something over there. Okay, this is trying to what's this? No. Editor, take a look at this.
Hey.
What is that?
Two reason.
Oh, okay. Orleans, Bramble. Playing by dance gets hobbled, stuck, paralyzed, attacks. Huh. Minus plus three damage reduction. Rings can feature bang bands, jewels. Okay, so this is a very good ring.
As you wish.
So apparently that's their handiwork. So charms, but this will add some additional protection for you.
Nothing over here. I guess they cleaned up real good after the battle. This is embarrassing.
My thoughts will be as silent as my feet.
We'll keep looking. Maybe we'll find something.
I think I see... No. Never mind.
quiet. Well.
Place forever. These ruins are claimed, friend. On your way.
Oh, really?
No need to get riled, boys. We're just passing by.
Look at his talisman, Pag. Aothasian.
Yeah, what of it?
How about that? A godless sack of shit. We got a blazing corpse worshiper on our hands.
Actually, they never found the body.
Only reason for the legacy is because the Duke doesn't got the guts to see you all slaughtered. The gods want you dead. Me and Pag, though, we've done our part during the purges, didn't we, Pag?
Seamstresses?
Make your cracks now. Got no god or homeland to avenge you. By Magrin, this'll be short work.
You always swear by your god when you do a devil's work.
Doesn't matter who it was for anyway. Country's better for the purges. Maybe we start a new purge right here.
We'll start a new graveyard, you fool. Your own first body, and I rip you to shreds. Little fool. Bury you. Little fool. Who's this? Not this little fool now. Shut this fool's mouth up forever. Running. Paralyze him. Don't be fools forever. Let him die for
well.
Let him die forever. In blindness and foolishness. Let him die forever. In blindness and foolishness. Hey, dude. What are you doing? Knock him down forever. He's blind now. Stick him for his foolishness. Let him die forever. Let his bones be forsaken. where he belonged.
They were right. That was short work.
His bones be forsaken. Clean his body up. He never even got that to fire. Little fool. Okay, Edward, we have something back there. Something else here. Greatest Syrian standard piece. The steel ornament once rested top of Greatest Syrian standard during the Saints' War. Is shaped to resemble a rising sun. Yeah. The tip of some metal object protrudes from a mound of watery river silt. Both hands, you and Edda begin digging in the mud till the object is dislodged. You close your hands around it and pull it from the wet earth. The object is steel, semicircular frame, about the size of your fist. At even points around the semicircle, jagged points jut out like tongues of flames. This rays of the rising sun. At the sun's center is the carved silhouette of a Vorlis plant.
I've seen these before. They top the standards of Raid Saris. Or did when Wideman was alive. Well, it's something. Just not sure what it gets me.
Takes it, flipping in his hand. Good with objects. I might be able to glean something from it. It's a thought. A lot of people wouldn't touch this. Standard bearer is a position of honor in most places. But the Raid of Sirens actually took to fighting for it. What I heard, serious bunch. It's not a lot to hang hopes on, but hey, we were lucky to find anything at all. He passes to KLB. Let's see what you can see. Better not make anything up, or you'll wake up one morning with snakes in your bedroll. Better not do that. You wake up with your head exploded, Edward. I mean that. You won't even wake up. Take the steel sun in one hand, pass Edward's hand with the other, ignoring his uncertain thoughts. Close your eyes and concentrate. The sun is bright in your mind's eye. Warm with the pulse of collective experience, and noisy with the thoughts of the past, a battle, a faith, a home. You drift from voice to voice, thought to thought, and his soul a vibrant signature with which to locate his brother. One voice stands out amidst the din, brassy and earnest, a shade brighter than Edward's, but unmistakably of the same construction. You know I have no image of its owner, but his journey is imprinted within the points and curves of the steel sun. And your mind opens before you as the path stretching both southward to Gilded Vale and northward over the uneven terrain that joins the Deerwood to Raid Saris. You trace the path back to its origin, far back as you can find, gliding over plains and hillsides to a one-room home in Gilded Vale with a thatched roof and a dirt floor. Path is faint here, its distance in time rendering images blurry and details scarce. From Gilded Vale, it follows a road towards Madman Bridge, reaching the gates of Defiance Bay, before diverting abruptly, cutting northward in a beeline for Raid Saris. The path leads to a Raid Saris city, regal and austere in a dear imperial style. It winds through streets and climbs a grand set of stairs into a stately building, passing through pointed archways to what appears to be a throne room. Upon the throne sits a man whose head is pure, blinding light. And as its gaze turns toward you, the light drowns out all else. Its voice carries the force of thunder, but its words are impossible to make out in the input. Echoes of echoes. Light and voice fade, and the path bends backwards, carrying you along to a barrack, then back southward, marching to Deerwood and skirmishing along the way. Upon one battlefield, the imprint is vivid, and you see a Raedusarian standard, topped with a steel stun, clutched in the hands of a fallen soldier. You see a young man in Raedusarian armor, with eddard straw-colored hair, race toward the standard and lift it up. The path you've been following clear to see beneath his feet. And as his hand brushes the steel tip, you can hear his thoughts racing in a blur there of his God and his country and a brother he hopes is far away from this place. In an instant, the thoughts are gone as well as the man, and the standard is passed under the soldier. You pick the path up again as it meanders south and disintegrates in the shadow of Cliaban Rilag. You open your eyes.
Anything? Looked like you were working real hard there.
Yeah. Put away that thought about those snakes. Better not try that. I mean it, Edder. Ever. Your brother got as far as Defiance Bay before turning to Raedusarius instead. He met waiting there. Then he enlisted.
Well, what'd he talk about with Widewind?
Widewind's head was a beam of light.
I figured that. Odin and me had heard enough stories from his uprising to know it wasn't just some tall tale. Doesn't mean he was Aethys. It could have been some wizard's trick. It's what they talked about that's important. What'd they say?
I don't know.
That's not funny. Come on. That metal sun, my brother touched it. You saw where he went. Now what'd he talk about with Widewind? Why'd my brother fight for Raedusarius?
Are you deaf? I said I don't know.
I guess that's it.
Find some other way to know why he did what he did.
I don't think we will. What will we do? Look for more war relics? We were lucky to find this one. Soldiers that fought with him are long dead. The battle was a massacre. Whatever Aethys knows, he's not talking to anyone.
We can go now. I've seen what I need to see. We are able to confirm that Edward's brother, Woden, fought for Raedusarius and even met Wayland himself. Prior to enlisting, but his actual reason for doing was lost. Edder will likely never know what inspired his brother to change his allegiance. You have to draw your own conclusions. I mean about the damn snakes. Should have lied to your ass. I didn't.
As you wish. A blade in the dark.
A broken bridge lies before you. Most of it appears to have crumbled into the river centuries ago, leaving two jagged ledges on either side of the water. Seen a yawning passage into the mountains on the other side, you might be able to jump across the gap. Jump to the other side. Aloth adjusts the gap and barely makes it across, spraying your wrist in the process. This might be our way in. the wrist. Well, darn. Okay. Keep your combat to rest up.
A blade in the dark.
Stop by a lurker. Very strong, tough, not really smart.
The beast that born you by killing you.
Thank you.
You will die, monster. Fire.
You have given that torch. That monster rope accident. Give it an eye of strike before you do that.
On that floor. Your thoughts must float.
This little monster damn near dead. Okay, well, alright, what else on this? Fire is it. Fire is their bane.
Ilof, give him some heat.
It's for you.
I felt the flames. Nicely done, Ilof.
You kept your hands clean. Let's gather, pick up these items. And we'll camp here by the end.
Of course.
Let's rest up. Oh, maybe these are the attributes they bring. Racial accuracy bonus. What will we encounter in here? I believe we are going to be. Guess is more spirit. Mm-hmm. feel her presence hovering near you. When you turn, you see the grieving mother observing you. Concern crinkles the corners of her eyes, seeps into her mind. You wear a cowl of your own, Watcher. I see you shrouded by old lies and unanswered questions. Can you see any details of my past life? She closes her eyes and you feel her energy directed inward at you. She searches your mind with memories, parts of you that feel numb and still. She is gentle as a mother with a newborn. Finally, she reads, I'm sorry. Whatever secrets your soul hides are not present in your mind. Yes, I've felt them more and more of late. This is why we journey together, that one may draw strength from many, and that much may be mended by the purpose of one. As she peers at you, her brow seems creased with a new kind of anxiety. Your obscure past, does it trouble you? Yes, I don't know what's in there, even though I have some suspicion. That's related to the man that I chased. I was a worshipper of Wardica. In my past lives, apparently. Take care, Watcher. Do not let the unknown chapters of your soul thwart your present endeavors. You must fortify your mind and find clarity and purpose. Thank you. She retreats from you, fading into the background. If you did not already know she was there, you'd suspect she wasn't. You wouldn't notice her at all. Fair warning, thank you. Let's put a finger in this page, and we'll be back soon. Thank you for watching. This has been Erik Malkavian, Among the Pillars of Eternity. These are the pillars of eternity, the people. Thank you for watching. I'll be back shortly.